Not much is known about George Foster other than he proudly served in WW2, whichever one that was, and he came back ready to get into business, any business. He was called in some articles an entrepreneur, and I suppose that's true. In 1946, George Foster decides to go into the ice cream game. He is said to be the first to bring soft serve to the West, but he was by no means the inventor of soft serve. Do you know the story of soft serve?
No, I hate that stuff. Why would I
look into it? First, to clarify the difference between soft serve and regular ice cream, because if you ask me, soft serve is just curly and it comes out of a machine looking like poop, but not according to science. There are two main differences between soft serve and regular ice cream. Soft serve has less milk fat, like 3-6% milk fat, while ice cream has 10-18%.
That's what people like about it. Like, a sign of good ice cream is the milk fat or whatever, the butter fat or whatever it is. So when you're taking it away, all you're getting is this is just like water. This is cold cream.
The other thing makes no sense to me, but it might to you. Soft serve has a higher air content. When air is added to soft serve,
this makes a lot of sense to me. Finish that sentence and then I'll tell you how I feel about air.
Oh. I'll tell you how I feel about you getting air, acting like it's a privilege. When air is added to soft serve ice cream, as it is frozen, it also affects the taste and the texture. So the taste and texture is different because of the air.
Right. So to speak about another type of ice cream, gelato, if it's like puffed up, like fluffed up, that's not good gelato. Like, you want it to be sort of like dense and sort of down because that's just pure, unrefined. That's the hard stuff.
I could feel the milk film in the back of my throat when I drink milk.
You shouldn't be drinking milk. That's your problem.
I'm not drinking milk. I'm just saying you're giving me the effect just to talking about dense cream. Yeah. Dense cream.
The butter fat.
I gotta go to the bathroom. Read this nonsense for me. I gotta go to the bathroom.
Read all these facts I have about aeration.
So the melty effect of soft serve is due to the air content, which is controlled by the soft serve machine, if I read that correctly. The machine gives it air just before it pours out and looking like poop. So the soft serve was initially invented by Tom Carvel of Carvel's Ice Cream New York. Yeah. It was invented when his ice cream truck broke down on a hot summer day in 1934, and the melting ice cream was a sudden accidental hit.
You're just proving my point that defective dying ice cream is soft serve.
I want that, but melty.
That's also interesting because I always kind of suspected that soft serve is more of an East Coast thing because my parents love soft serve and I don't like it. And whenever you go to New York, like, it's always like, this is the best ice cream place. This is just a soft serve cone.
So 2 years later in Illinois, Dairy Queen made their own soft serve machine and started selling that out of a brick and mortar store in 1940. So now we cut back to George Foster, 1946, seeking success from sweets. He purchased the development rights for the whole state of California from the Dairy Queen, which meant he can open his own Dairy Queens in California. His intentions was, like I just said, to open Dairy Queens across the state, but there was an issue. It was either one of the two things, and I read both of them. Either he learned that the dairy industry had enacted strict laws controlling the word dairy, so he couldn't call it Dairy Queen, or the name Dairy Queen was already being used in another fashion in California.
Dairy Duke.
Dairy Princess. Heir to the throne.
Dairy next in line and for royal lineage.
Dairy Harry.
You feeling aerated?
So anyways, he couldn't call his new franchise that he just paid money for Dairy Queen. So what are you going to do? But either way, he would be selling ice cream out of a place that looked and felt suspiciously like a Dairy Queen, but had a different name. It seems like it seems like it would have hindered his ability to gain.
Is this a Dilly Bar? No, it's a Billy Bar.
It seems like it would have hindered his ability to gain customers based on brand recognition, but it also seemed like it would work in his favor having his name be the company name. So he changed the name from Dairy Queen to Foster's Old Fashioned Freeze.
To Foster's the New King. I think that's what kind of confused me about it, why I thought it was always just kind of like slushy sort of things, because the word freeze to me brings certain connotations.
Yeah, freeze is a completely different thing. I think it's just like a colder smoothie.
Yeah. They put too much ice in the smoothie.
Original name was Foster's Old Fashioned Freeze. It later became known as Foster Freeze. My family and I for years have called it Frosty Freeze. Not Foster's, not Frosty Freeze, Frosty Freeze.
Wait a minute, so it's called not Foster's, just Foster Freeze?
Foster Freeze. He like later lost the apostrophe S. Yes. So
Dairy's Queen.
Somebody else jumped on it. The first location opened up in Inglewood on La Brea Avenue near 94th Street, 999 South La Brea Avenue. That location is still there, but I believe the structure has completely changed.
You were there recently.
Yeah, I was out there, so I stopped by. And I thought, man, this place is going to be great. And I thought, the one by my house is better. It's still there, though. The original menu had items like the soft serve. You had malts and shakes, sundaes, orange freezes, root beer floats. And slowly over the next couple
years. You did freezes, orange freezes.
Slowly over the next couple of years, the menu expands from frozen treats to foods, and Foster starts serving
frozen foods.
I guess I have a TV dinner in here I can make. Do you like Salisbury steak? Do you like kind of corn?
Do you like a brownie that was covered in plastic? Is that what you like?
Leave the film on it. So yeah, after that, they start serving burgers and fries, and it becomes like a legitimate Southern California hamburger stand.
It just became Dairy Queen.
Pretty much, yeah. And it becomes like fully realized with the company's Googie-style architecture, which featured angled sky blue roofs, beautiful neon signage, and walk-up windows. So it was like quintessential 50s, 60s yeah. California kind of thing. They were becoming popular, and before the end of 1950, Foster had opened up 360 locations statewide. All of those 360 good locations used a soft serve machine mix from a company called Compton Dairy, which I sadly couldn't find too much about, but I did find an article from 1927 saying that Compton was the leading dairy section of the country, which I find interesting.
Those Compton cows. Straight out of Compton's udders. Anyways, that's what he used to say on milk cartons. Straight out of Compton's.
This milk is straight out of Compton.
Nitrates with attitude.
Anyways, by 1951, Foster buys out of the soft serve game and sells his franchise for $1 million. Back then was $1 million.
$1 million has always been worth $1 million.
That's a set exchange. He sold it to the Meyenberg Milk Products Company, thus ending a big account for Compton Dairy. The franchise has had many owners over time from all different walks of life, and over the years, the number of locations has dwindled down to 81, with real estate costs in California being the main aspect to blame, as well as the fast food and ice cream company competition throughout Southern California.
Yeah, there's not too many of that, like I was saying.
And there's, I can name five, including the original one.
I just kind of pass them randomly, yeah. And it never seems like they're open.
A hamburger stand is neat, but it's not a drive-through in Car Central, and that really would keep you alive. It kind of matters. It's hard to keep up with McDonald's and Dairy Queen when you're a Foster's Freeze. You know?
Classic saying. It's hard to keep up with Dairy Queen and McDonald's when you're just a Foster Freeze.
I think that John F. Kennedy said that.
That's my John F. Kennedy.
It's pretty good. His last words. Luckily, in 1994...
Everybody... Get a load of this. Hoo-ah!
Dealey Plaza, I'd like your attention for a moment. Luckily, in 1994, an agreement was signed with the El Pollo Loco chain to serve up Foster's Freeze soft serve ice cream and other of its products at their locations, which added more than 160 additional locations where the company's products were sold. So
it's a parasite. It's a parasite that chicken gets.
There's a sense of nostalgia around Foster's Freeze for SoCal people, and I'm one of those people. You know, I really have like idyllic memories of Foster's Freeze. My Aunt Sue used to live in Atwater.
Fosty Freeze?
Yeah, Fosty's Freeze. My Aunt Sue used to live in Atwater, and us kids on summer vacation, we'd all walk over. She'd take like six kids to Foster's Freeze, and that's the same Foster's Freeze that's in both Pulp Fiction when Butch sees Marcellus Wallace across the street and he hits him. Foster's Freeze is in the background.
You saw that happen.
That's my Foster's Freeze. The Glendale location on Grandview and Glen Oaks just closed recently. That was one of the first places I drove to when I started driving on my own. There's so many posts and articles in small town like newspapers and blogs that report how sad people are when their local Foster's closes. There's articles and posts written about how heroes will step up and save a Foster's from demolition. Many of the original 40s locations still stand in Los Angeles area. There's like Burbank, Atwater, Eagle Rock has one, but a lot of them are in the South Bay. You know, there's like Carson, Torrance, Wilmington, Hawthorne.
Yeah,
a lot
it feels
of them,
like a South Bay thing.
Yeah, it has like a beach sensibility
yeah,
to it.
Yeah, it does.
Foster's Freeze has its corporate headquarters in Rancho Cucamonga, so it still is a Southern...
It's the perfect name for an ice cream place to have headquarters.
Now for a bit of Southern California lore that needs to be addressed. It's 1964, and the Beach Boys have a hit, Fun, 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 which was a true account of a girl getting her dad's T-bird taken away after meeting Dennis Wilson, the handsomest beach boy and also the only one that surfed. The opening line is, well, she got her daddy's car and she cruised through the hamburger stand now. That hamburger stand has long supposed to be a Foster's Freeze, the one in Hawthorne, although A&W Root Beer Beer is containing that.
Oh, come on.
That's them.
No.
A&W, come on. You're more of a Jan and Dean type.
You knockoff wannabe Jan and Dean loser.
Foster's has...
I'm glad I got that off my chest.
So on top of the delicious soft serve, Foster's has a delicious burger menu as well.
I missed the word. How did you refer to it?
Foster's has a delicious burger menu. My favorite is the Big Boss, which has onion rings in the burger. There's great hot dogs.
What do they call it in France? We're talking about Pulp Fiction, right?
It's a lay big boss. It's a communist country, so they don't have bosses.
Yeah, France
there.
Is a communist. It's the boss that nobody respects because they're all socialists.
Nobody works cheese. Over there. There's hot dogs, there's chili, mozzarella sticks, pastrami, burritos at some locations. There's patty melts. They have their soft serves, like I said. They have them dipped in vanilla and chocolate.
Okay, that
delicious.
I will give you. That a soft serve, if it's dipped in a hard shell sort of thing, that is good.
Can you kiss the ring and say it? Thank you.
Delicious.
I dipped it. They have freezes, which come in banana berry, mocha, and root beer. They have sundaes and milkshakes and parfaits and twisters.
What's a twister?
What's a twister?
Oh, it's a twister. I think that's the one where they turn it upside down. Like they serve it to you upside down.
That's a blizzard.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
From a company they're not allowed to be associated. Yeah, that's what they did. They just stole it since they stole everything else from Dairy Queen.
Hey.
By the way, when I said, what's a twister, I was expecting you to say, this is a twister and twist my nipples.
Oh, that's funny.
Please do it.
I brought the clothespins. Please do it.
The gag's already in my mouth. Please do it, Greg. I beg you. What's a twister?
Yeah, that's it.
You sold me on it. I really like to go to one.
Let's go around.
Okay.
Let's go around.
All right. Bye.
I'll eat it for you, and you can watch my body just turn into mashed potatoes.